Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So on today's video, we're going to be using the launch tool right here to program a key for the Lexus GX470. I had an extra key laying around from the previous one that my father-in-law had, that one that got totaled. So I'm going to go ahead and try to program this to his new one. Even though the key is different, I wanted to program the remote and the immobilizer to his car, so when we cut a new one, we can just swap the remote over. So stay tuned. So right here, I've got the key that goes to the new GX470, and I got the old one that got totaled that he still had the key laying around. So we're gonna go ahead and program this to the car today. I'm about to undo the internals because I need to do a quick swap for them in the middle of the programming, because I still need the key shank to turn once I put it in there for the immobilizer, because this one won't work. So I can just swap the guts out in the middle of the programming, and that way it'll read and it'll program. In addition to doing the immobilizer, I'll do the remote using the launch tool too. So I took the covers off. So if you watched my videos in the past, I usually get these shanks cut by 1010 keys on eBay. They do the cut by code and cut by photo of your key. They're pretty affordable. I think it's only $15 for a new shank and key cut, which is a deal considering the dealer wants like freaking $50 just to cut it, and you have to get your own key or you buy one of them from there. The insides of both of these are both OEM remotes, as you can see by that H and everything here. So that's a good sign right there. So I'm gonna go ahead and bring it over to the car and easily swap it between the two. I don't even need the actual key here. I just need the actual internals, because I'm gonna just swap them in and out. If you watch my previous videos on the launch tool, I've gone over all the different features of this thing. It's a very useful tool for like $150. It does everything techstream does. So if you want to try out this tool, go ahead and check out the links down in the description. I'll have that link plus the link to 1010 keys, where I get all my keys for my Lexus vehicles. So we'll go ahead and let this thing scan, figure out what vehicle you have, and then get into the menus. So right now it's just scanning the vehicle, getting all the codes, but once we get into there, we'll go ahead and show you what the menus are to do the key programming. One of the things, as such, with a lot of these 15, 16 year old vehicles, all the TPMS sensors are out of batteries. So you can see 3 of my 5 on here are out of batteries, which we still haven't fixed or replaced on there. I have a wheel speed signal issue right here. I'm not sure what that is, but that's for the air suspension. It doesn't pop up on the screen or anything, but it is stored in the ECU. So after we're scanning all the codes, we want to scroll down to the immobilizer and all this to go to that particular control unit. So you hit the check mark. It'll ask you about that ECU. So we're going here, and you want to go to special features. And then in here, you could basically erase all your transponders, you could program new ones, you could do other customizable settings down here. So we'll go ahead and do key registration, and then this basically says, it tells you what it does, you hit OK, and then this goes through the whole wizard right here, and then you want to hit OK. Here it'll give you all the instructions, so you want to perform the following. So the clock is actually starting to tick right now, so you want to perform all these things within the 120 seconds right there. So we'll go back and just start this over, so that way we have the full 2 minutes. Alright, we're in the programming mode right now, so it's trying to register it. We're going down 59 seconds. This is doing a countdown to register, so hopefully it registers. So master key registration is complete. Right here, so we're gonna hit okay. Insert, and then we're gonna try to test it to see if it works. So there it is, that new transponder is registered. So now I gotta do the remote for it. So now that we're done with this, we're gonna go back. We're gonna end session. And then we want to go ahead and go to the remote now. We gotta go out of this menu, go look for the, I think it's under the body control module. And this is where it's not user friendly. You kind of got to just search around for stuff. So you want to go under special features. And then you want to go wireless registration right here. And then you want to go through here and just go through this. So you want to do, is ignition is on, wait at least 30 seconds after ignition before clicking OK. Hey, driver's side is open and all other doors closed and driver's side is unlocked. So we wanna go ahead and do that. Leave the door open, hit this thing, okay. And then you wanna go, I have two and I got two more. And then in the next screen, you wanna go on the remote, push lock and unlock. On the next, see. So within 30 seconds, you wanna hit lock and unlock on here. So lock is the button, this button right here with a dot on it. Unlock is that one. And then within 3 seconds, press lock and unlock again for 1 second. Oh, you have to put it simultaneously, so I gotta put the camera down. Alright, so we just registered this second one, so the remote on here works. So I went ahead and turned off the car. I've got the key right there and I got the new remote. I want to go lock and unlock. So everything works on here, so this thing's programmed to the car now and it will start the car. So another good thing with this launch tools, it does customizable settings. So you go in here on the body control module, and it'll go through all the different things that you could personalize and adjust on here, like the wireless door locks, security, your wipers. You could set the wipers to re-wipe again after a certain amount of time when you do the mist or when you wash the windows. So you just go into here and it'll basically guide you through all the different customizations if you have to do that in this tool. So rewipe control, auto wiper, and the speed mode. So those are various things that you may or may not have that option on your version. Other settings like your lock settings right here, you can set customizable to whatever you want as far as when it auto locks, it auto unlocks, and then same with your buttons. So unlock with park, that's on. So when it goes into park, it unlocks the car. And you can also do auto. So this one is within 10 seconds if you open it. If you don't do the park one, then you do this one. It only opens when you open your driver's side one within 10 seconds. So that's a good setting if you want to set it where you're a female and you don't want all your doors opening when you park. So I'm gonna set that on right there. And then I'm gonna turn off the putting it in park. It's good. The key unlocked twice to unlock all the doors versus once. You want the auto lock. So that one functions to lock all doors when you shift it from the parking range. That's on, so this is, so you could hear that lock earlier. And then the auto lock, this one's when you hit a certain speed. So again, if you want to do it where you start driving off to lock, then you could turn this on and then turn the park one off. security. So this thing's for the various security settings, like if you have a glass break sensor and all that stuff, you could turn this on and off. And you could also do the passive mode, which you probably don't want, because this thing will automatically go into security setting even if your doors are open. Illuminated entry, turn those things on and off there. Light control. So for light control, these are just the various settings. Actually, I'm gonna turn off the DRLs on here so I don't burn out those bulbs on here, because that thing uses the turn signal. So I'm gonna turn that off on here. We don't need those things. So we're gonna turn that off. Then we're gonna do the rest of these right here, which is gonna be the display sensitivity. So a lot of these settings might be in your nav menu also, but you can also do it here. So this is the delay to turn off the light. So it's 30 seconds when you walk away. So I turned off those DRLs. So right now they're not on anymore. So some of you guys that don't like that thing being on all the time and burning out your headlights, that might be an option for you to turn that off. Other options, including your tilt steering wheel right here, you could turn that system or that feature on and off. Smart access, nothing there because we don't have smart key on this car. The seat, these are probably part of your customizable seat settings and everything here. So for the seat settings, there's actually nothing in here to change or customize. So yeah, as you can see, lots of little features that turn on your different convenience things for the GX470 here. So this tool does it all, and you could program it all. Hey guys, thanks for joining me on this quick video on doing all the settings and doing the keys for the GX470. If you found the video useful, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to your channel, go ahead and subscribe to your channel. Turn on bell notifications to get notified every time I upload a video. For all these different projects, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you guys next time.